So you're in the market for a brand new real estate agent website, but you don't know where to begin. Well, I have some great news for you. I've been in this real estate web development game for well over a decade now, and I wanna be your guide. Today, we're talking about how to pick the right real estate agent website developer for your website. So you're a brand new real estate agent, or maybe you're a veteran, but at the end of the day, you need to get your real estate website either done or revamped. The problem is you do not know where to begin. There are a ton of options out there, either doing a simple Google search or maybe through your referral network, but the problem is you don't know who to trust or who's qualified. Well, I've been in the real estate industry for a very long time now, so I'm hoping that I can provide you with some guidance when it comes to picking the right real estate agent website developer for your website. And the good news is I've boiled it down to a checklist with just three items. But before I get into it, please, please, please smash that like button. It really helps get our video out there. It appeases the YouTube gods, and it really helps support our channel. Now, as I said earlier, picking a website developer isn't as hard or as time consuming as you may think. It's really a checklist that boils down to three main items. And those items are experience, scope, and follow-up. Now, let me break this down to help you understand each point a little more clearly. First, let's talk experience. Experience really boils down to four main categories. Category number one is understanding the MLS. The funny thing about the real estate industry is it is a very niche industry, and you need to find a web developer that understands the terminology. That being said, you need to make sure you find a web developer that understands the difference between IDX, RETS, and all of the other different technology that's available out there in terms of manipulating property data. By the way, I highly recommend you check out the video that we did on understanding how to load properties to your website. It kind of sheds some light and some clarity into how all of this stuff works. I'll leave the link in the description below. Category number two is your web developer's background. You want to make sure you hire a web developer that is familiar with the industry. So I highly recommend you take a look at their website and make sure that it is real estate industry specific. Which leads to category number three, portfolio. Now, if you're on your website, please make sure you take a look at their previous work. Most web developer websites will have a section for case studies or websites that they've successfully launched, and you're gonna wanna make sure that they have at least a few examples of real estate specific websites. And category number four is reviews. I cannot preach the value of social proof enough. Make sure you do a Google search for that web developer and read what other clients have said. Spending a little time looking at social proof will pay huge dividends at the end. Okay, now let's talk about item number two on your checklist, which is scope. When it comes to building a website, it boils down to two options, renting or owning. Without getting ingrained into too much of the minutia between the two, let me simplify and break down kind of the pros and cons of each. Now, most larger scale lead generation web developer companies, like for example, a Boomtown or a Playster, allow you to build out a real estate agent website. However, these are rentals. A great pro of having a rental is that you have the backing of a large company behind you, plus they have additional technology features that you typically won't have building your own website. However, you are paying a monthly subscription to these companies, and the minute you stop paying, they're gonna turn your website off. Now, the pro of owning your own website is just like it sounds, you own it. Now, in the event that you decide to fire your website developer, move your site to a different server, or you know, do anything specific or customizable to your website, you're not handcuffed to a contract. You can do whatever you'd like with it. However, if you do decide to pivot, you do not have the backing of a large company behind you, so you kind of have to fend for yourself. Another consideration when it comes to scope is understanding what you're getting for what you're paying for. Now, when you're building out the scope of your website or maybe talking to a developer about this, you want to make sure that you have a very, very clear vision of what your goals are. For example, standard real estate agent websites are typically built with WordPress and utilize some sort of IDX. But if your vision is beyond that, like integrating a CRM or email marketing, you have to make sure that that is clear. The last thing to consider is the technology stack, which plays a factor into the price. Now, as I mentioned, most real estate agent websites are built with WordPress. That's simply because they are very easy to manage and very easy to maintain. However, if you did want to go with a custom option, then there are definitely a few things you need to consider. For instance, if you're trying to build a web application, for example, you want to integrate machine learning into your website because you want to use predictive analytics for a specific community, then yes, absolutely go with your own standalone solution. Aside from that, WordPress with IDX is probably your way to go. Lastly, item number 3 on our checklist is the follow-up for after your website is launched. It is very easy to get sucked into the minutia of website development monthly fees. So I'd like to spend a second debunking what those monthly fees typically are so you're better informed. Typical website monthly fees boil down to 3 categories: hosting, maintenance, and data. Now, when it comes to hosting, don't get blown away by all the cool terminology and lingo. A simple website host from either Google, Amazon, or even GoDaddy is pretty much all you need to get by. Now, when it comes to website maintenance, your website developer should leave your website in a position where you yourself or maybe your assistant can manage. Do not get suckered into a monthly maintenance fee unless you really need someone to manage that website. Lastly, when it comes to data, it really just boils down to your IDX. Your IDX requires a monthly data subscription that is paid to your MLS. That fee is typically around $50 plus minus if you want additional functions or features that your IDX company provides. Aside from that, if you're looking for any other feature like a CRM or email marketing, those data fees are outside of the scope of the website. And when it comes to email marketing, going with something like a HubSpot, a Constant Contact, or a MailChimp is probably your way to go. But keep in mind that the fees do fluctuate based off of the amount of contacts that you have. Now, to wrap things up, I want you to go through this checklist and set clear expectations for each one of these items. When you start interviewing web developers, start checking off the items in this checklist. And if something doesn't sound right to you or doesn't align with your vision, then, you know, move on to the next person and start over again. At the end of the day, I want to make sure you understand that hiring a web developer is not just a one-time gig. This is a person that you're potentially going to be spending a long-term relationship and business partnership with. And just like any business partnership, you're gonna have your share of frustrations and disagreements. So you wanna make sure that you're really jive with a person that you're gonna potentially hire, because this is gonna be a long-term play and this person is gonna be around constantly making changes and iterations to your website for a very long time. Now, I hope you found this video helpful. And if you did, please, please, please hit that like button and maybe drop a comment below. We really appreciate it. And also, do not forget to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon so you make sure you get notified whenever we're pushing out brand new videos. Thanks so much, and we'll see you on the next video.